A new era for humankind. NASA smashes asteroid. This is News Review from BBC Learning English. I'm Neil.
And I'm Beth. Make sure you watch to the end to learn vocabulary to talk about today's story.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like this video, and try the quiz on our website. Now it's time for the story.
Protecting our Earth from space rocks. NASA has successfully crashed a DART spacecraft into an asteroid as part of a defense test. It's hoped scientists will learn more about pushing dangerous asteroids off course. Dr. Lori Glaze, the Director of Planetary Science at NASA, called it a new era for humankind.
You've been looking at the headlines, Beth. What's the vocabulary?
We have bullseye, rams, and unprecedented.
This is News Review from BBC Learning English. Let's have a look at our first headline.
This one is from the Irish Times. Bullseye. NASA successfully smashes spacecraft into asteroid 11 million kilometers from Earth.
And so the meaning of this headline is that NASA have smashed a spacecraft into an asteroid. An asteroid is a really big rock floating in space. And to smash something means to hit it really, really hard. But the word we are concentrating on is bullseye, and it's a word from sport, isn't it?
Yes. Now, the spacecraft was called DART, and darts is a game or a sport where you throw a small arrow, called a dart, into the center target, which is called a bullseye. Now, if you hit that, you get a lot of points, and when you hit it, you say...
Bullseye! And so the headline writer is saying that NASA hit this asteroid exactly in the right place, and they are using the word bullseye because the spacecraft is called DART, so it's a bit of a joke. But can we use the word beyond sport?
Well, we often say it when we get the exact result that we wanted. It's a bit similar to yes or I did it, but it's only really used for sports and games normally.
Right, okay. So if I take this piece of paper and I try to hit the camera lens right in the middle, I can say, bullseye! Okay, let's have a look at that again. Let's have a look at our next headline.
This one comes from Bloomberg. NASA craft rams distant asteroid in test of Earth defense.
The headline is saying that NASA did this experiment as a test of defense, and defense is an activity designed to stop something bad happening. In this case, an asteroid hitting the Earth. But the word we're looking at is ram. Now, Beth, a ram is a kind of animal, isn't it?
Yes, a ram is actually a male sheep, and they smash into things really hard with their head.
Okay, tell us more.
So imagine this action as a verb, to ram. It means to push or hit something very violently. Now, we know that the spacecraft hit the asteroid and was actually destroyed when that happened, so it really rammed it. It hit it hard.
Okay, ram as a verb then means to hit something really hard. We're not talking about a little knock or a tap. Imagine the police trying to open the door of a building they want to go in. They will ram it. If you're in a car accident, a car can ram into you. There is another word connected to ram. Rammed as an adjective has a different meaning, doesn't it? It means really busy, crowded.
Yeah, exactly. So if you imagine almost that the people have been pushed or rammed into a very tight space, it's very busy. So we can say it's rammed. Have you been anywhere that was rammed recently, Neil?
Yes, my train into work this morning was absolutely rammed. It was full of people. That's a quite informal way of describing it, isn't it?
Yeah, so if you want to use it in a situation that isn't informal, you might just say it's overcrowded or busy.
Okay, let's look at that again. Our next headline, please.
This one comes from CBC. We have impact. NASA slams spacecraft into asteroid in unprecedented test.
The headline says that NASA slammed a spacecraft into an asteroid. Slammed is another word like smashed and rammed that we've heard already, meaning hit very hard. But we are looking at the word unprecedented.
We are, and unprecedented is an adjective. It means something that hasn't happened before or something that we haven't known until now.
And so the headline describes the test as unprecedented. They've never done this before. They haven't tried to push an asteroid off its course ever before. Now this word unprecedented, it's used a lot, isn't it?
Yeah, we see it all the time in the news. I mean, the news is all about new events. So recently we've heard about unprecedented levels of rainfall. We've also heard about unprecedented rises in prices of gas, for example.
Yeah, and those are all very serious things. And so unprecedented is often used for more kind of formal situations. For example, my son, if he did an exam at school, he got a really high mark. I wouldn't say, oh, Beth, my son got an unprecedented mark in his exam.
No, you definitely wouldn't. You'd just say maybe it's the best result he's ever had.
Okay, let's have a look at that again. We've had bullseye. I hit the target.
Rams. Crashes into something violently.
And unprecedented. This has never happened before.
Don't forget, there is a quiz on our website, bbclearningenglish.com.
Thank you for joining us, and goodbye.
Bye.